In the last lecture, I have explained you about MAC instruction, MAC. In digital signal processors, MAC instruction is implemented as MACD, multiply and accumulate with data shift, MACD instruction. A MACD instruction requires four set of operations. One is instruction fetch, second one is data fetch, third one is data fetch, fourth one is write results. A MACD instruction requires one instruction cycle. One instruction cycle means instruction fetch, data fetch, data fetch, write results. If this MACD instruction is executed on conventional microprocessor like 8086, it requires 4 clock periods, that is, one instruction cycle of MACD requires 4 clock pulses on conventional microprocessor. This is because in conventional microprocessors, the architecture is von Neumann architecture. What is this von Neumann architecture? Von Neumann architecture consists of stored program concept. That is, in one memory, you will have data as well as program. This is von Neumann architecture consisting of control unit, processing unit, and data and program memory. Control unit has access to data and program memory. Control unit has access to processing unit. If you look carefully this block diagram, the instruction fetch will come from data and program memory to control unit. This requires one clock cycle. Next requires data fetch. This one requires another clock cycle. Second data fetch requires third clock cycle, and after completion of execution of MACD instruction, the results will be written back to program and data memory. It will require one clock cycle. If you add these four clock cycles, you will get four clock cycles. That is, the instruction execution cycle on general purpose microprocessor requires 4 clock pulses. If we want to have the speed improvement, we need to reduce these number of clock cycles. For this one, the architecture of DSP processors will use Harvard architecture. What is this Harvard architecture? The Harvard architecture consisting of two different memories, one for program memory, one for data memory. What is the advantage of having one program memory and one data memory differently? The advantage is you can have separate address lines to program memory, and you can access simultaneously instructions. Same way, you may have one address line for the data memory. That is, parallelly you can access two data elements. That is, one instruction you can access data. In one cycle, you will have access to two operands, that is, instruction fetch as well as data fetch. These two are completed in one clock cycle. And in the next clock cycle, another data fetch and computation of the results and writing back results to the data memory requires another clock cycle. So if you add these two, it is two clock cycles. If you compare von Neumann architecture and Harvard architecture, the number of clock cycles required to complete one instruction cycle, that is the MACD instruction execution, requires only two clock pulses on Harvard architecture, whereas four clock pulses on von Neumann architecture. So, von Neumann architecture is not used for digital signal processors. Whereas Harvard architecture is used for digital signal processors. Further, to increase the speed, that is to reduce the number of clock cycles from 2 to 1, there is one more architecture called modified Harvard architecture. In modified Harvard architecture, another separate data line will be there from that memory to from data memory to program memory, whereby you can access 3 data elements simultaneously. So now the instruction cycle will require only one clock period, you will have access to 3 data elements. Thank you. Increasing the number of data bus and address bus and having 2 separate memories will improve the speed. This completes the bus structures of programmable digital signal processors. Thank you.